Jurors have only another half hour tonight to try to reach a verdict for the Warren County man accused of drowning his wife in their bathtub.
Now, the trial wrapped up just this afternoon, right around 2 o'clock today, and Ryan Widmer did not testify in his own defense, but boy, plenty were said on his behalf. And News 5's Karin Johnson is live tonight in Warren County with our number one story. Karin?
Well, Cherie, that's right. The judge just said that he will be sending the jurors home around 6:30 tonight, so it looks like there will be no verdict tonight. They have been deliberating for about 4 hours so far, and prior to deliberations, Ryan's family, friends, court personnel, and even Sarah's mom packed into a courtroom for closing arguments.
Members of the jury, when you look at...
Jurors looked at a picture of Sarah Widmer as prosecutors began explaining to them why they should find Ryan Widmer guilty of murder. They began by playing the 911 call.
He says, "My wife fell asleep in the bathtub." He's beginning with his alibi. He's beginning with his defense.
Then changed their focus to the bathtub. Ryan claims he found Sarah dead in it, then pulled her out and began CPR.
You've got clothing. You've got towels. You've got things on the vanity. None of them are disturbed. How is that possible, even if he's struggling to take her out of the bathtub? It's not reasonable.
The defense began by painting a picture of two newlyweds in love, then blamed police for jumping to wrong conclusions while not properly processing an alleged crime scene. Too many holes that can't be filled, including State's Exhibit 44, a piece of carpet that Sarah's body was on.
Take a look at this bag. It was obviously a wet sample that was put inside of the bag. And that's the sample that was below Sarah's abdomen.
The defense also brought up mistakes made by first responders.
You have to doubt the ability of people who were incapable of intubating her at least 5 times. You have to doubt people who took her out of the house and then sat in the ambulance for 12 minutes before they left.
And you could see the small group of people gathered outside the courtroom. That's Ryan's dad and some other relatives and some friends. I have not seen Ryan all afternoon after deliberations. He left with his brothers, his mom, and he has not been back. But the folks who are here are really just patiently and anxiously waiting a verdict. Reporting live tonight in Lebanon, Karin Johnson, News 5.
Karin, you mentioned that the jurors would be going home around 6:30 tonight if they don't reach a verdict. Was there any talk of sequestering them, especially considering their juror misconduct in the first trial?
You know, Cherie, I asked folks who works in Judge Bronson's office that, and they said, you know, they haven't sequestered a jury in 8 years here, so that was unlikely. They haven't made any arrangements, so that is highly unlikely. So there really haven't been much talks about that at all.
All right, Karin Johnson reporting live. We'll check back if anything does happen in the next half hour. Karin, thank you.